Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Just a short time ago, these Philly fans in full roar as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. Pyrotechnics ablaze. They're set to go as their Eagles will match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. First down, Brady rolling to his right. He's got his big tight end, Gronkowski. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. Now a first carry for Giovanni Bernard. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Throwing is Brady on third down. Sliding out of the pocket. Dumps it off to Fournette. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. It'll be a loss of 2 on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. Steps away. That's complete to Tyler Johnson. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Let's go, defense. Let's go.
Miles Sanders, first carry of the game. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady gain.
Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. That swung out wide to Sanders. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for...
And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Shaquille Barrett gets him for a loss of 10 yards from his linebacker spot. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
The kick by Elliott is good. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And a short kick taken at about the 16. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. set to begin their next possession. Throwing on first down is Brady. He drops it off for Bernard. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. To throw is Brady, rolling to his left, and his throw is going to be incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Second and 10. Now Brady, and a little floater there is incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Again, they'll throw with Brady, out to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run, deep left side. That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A big connection on that one. 37 yards. Into the red zone, it's Brady. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And the Bucs are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Fournette. And he stopped immediately there. Oh, he fakes a spike. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete. This Eagle defense, they won't give in without a fight. This is third and goal. Now Brady. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans there to make the grab. And the Bucs have taken the lead. Brady will look to throw for it. It's caught at the one. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. And around the goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it, because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius, as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. On first and 10, it's Hurts. Left side here to Sanders. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Shaquille Barrett picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
A Well, here's where having mobility sometimes can work against you as a quarterback. He thinks he can retreat and outrun the pressure. But that time, they zeroed in on him and took him down for a big loss, partner.
A really big loss. On third down, they turn to Sanders. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down. Here's Aaron Sipos now. Struck, and the Bucs are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession, and we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead, not a whole lot of time left. What do you think? Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox, and great field position coming up in the red zone at the 17-yard line. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. His throw caught right around the six. And the Eagles are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the five.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
And Goddard's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Dallas Goddard as the first half is winding down. And the Eagles on just two plays have taken the lead. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And this is caught at the five. And he gets in. And no one was expecting a fake there, but they add two more onto their lead. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Offense set to begin their next possession, and we'll see what they opt to do with just 14 seconds remaining until intermission. And opening there on that first down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so second and 2. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break.
Both these teams making their final halftime adjustments. We're just about ready to get back to football. So for the call of the second half, we get back up to Philadelphia and Brandon Gott.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Second and 10 now, third quarter action from Philadelphia, PA. On play action, it's Brady. This is caught by Evans. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Again, it's Brady. He'll buy some time right. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Anthony Harris. And the Eagles are going to get the football here as he gets this up past the 20-yard line. Well, he went on the move there and started rolling out. I thought there was a window, but that window closed quickly, intercepted.
And sometimes, despite how big your arm talent is, you don't get enough on a throw when you're on the move as opposed to setting your feet and stepping into one. That may have been the case there, and the defense certainly benefited.
Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
And they have just not been able to block him at all throughout this game. Seems like every other play, he's doing something in the backfield. Already got two sacks, and now here's a tackle behind the line.
Now a throw here to his running back. And some room to work. He gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A big play that time on the catch and run.
He was not the primary target. They expected to get the ball downfield. Instead, checked it down. And old coach of mine used to say to us all the time, when they check it down, that should end the down. In this case, though, he foiled that in a big way and turned it into a big play.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. From the gun, it's Hurts. Open man has got it, the tight end.
When the offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because there should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback, a hot route, so to speak.
On first down, it's Sanders, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Hurts. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And the Buccaneers are going to get the football back as time will run out in this third quarter of play. So it'll be a change of possession on the turnover when we get back. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. The interception was a great starting point, but now they need points pretty quickly, down two scores. So after the INT, it's Brady on the move to his left. And this is caught by Evans. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
But correct me if I'm wrong, yeah, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
On first and 10, here's Brady. They'll roll him out right. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Anthony Harris, and the return stops at the 39-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Quick slant here to Smith. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
Another nice pickup through the air. And I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon. But with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. It's caught by Sanders. And down inside the 15 he goes.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this point. You just go,
touchdown! That's caught. Devontae Smith from 13 yards out. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points. An important score there, CD, and now an important extra point because it would make it a 3-score game.
Love the map there, and at this point in the fourth.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. It's caught at the 5. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. And that's something you almost never see nowadays. When you fake it, you're at the 15-yard line on a PAT as opposed to just going for it from the 2.
I'm sorry. I know they got it, and congratulations to them, but it's just not a good play. I mean, the risk-reward is really off the charts. Not in your favor. Run your offense out there. Put it on the 2-yard line if you want to go for 2. But I'll be darned. They ended up getting that one, didn't they?
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again.
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column.
A nice run there by Sanders on first down as he'll wind up with a gain of about 7 before he's brought down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. And a short gain down to about the 33. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Oh, they would have gotten a conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be 4th down.
One of the best routes, one of the favorite routes of any play caller,
He just ran that one. Nice little angle route. That's supposed to be a catch, and usually it is, and the running back dropped it.
Yeah, I mean, he's a running back, but he's got hands. He should have caught it. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Here's Hurts to throw. He'll get this complete to Jalen Reagor. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And the Eagles are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. That one looks like he'll throw here. Throw left side complete. That's Sanders. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. So it's a victory here for the Philadelphia Eagles. It was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.